Mayong gabi sa tanan. Salamat mga kids sa inyong presentation. Mapuslan, mangali ang mga uniform sa United Nations. Pwede tagali magamit sa simbahan. Kaya itaguan nyo lang kada tuig kay gamiton, tana kada missions manta. Okay, and we praise God that we have now reached the last night sa atong missions conference. Kag as the last night, kabay pagid nga, hindi niya mangin last, kundi mangin sugod. Another start as a church where we can be more intentional collectively bilang isa ka iglesia, and also individually as we, in our own respects, in our own circle of influence, will be able to each one reach one. No? Kaya sa sininga gabi, I just would like to share to you ang atong last night nga message, which will be entitled The Price to Gain. And I just would like to read Romans chapter 10, verse 15. And how shall they preach unless they are sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace, who bring glad tidings of good things. Sa pagtuunta sa pulong sa Ginoo, mapray ta, Father, we thank you for this time that we have reached the last night of our missions conference here in church. We thank you, Father, for the blessings that we have learned from your word, from the songs that encourages us to reach out to others, and even, Father, from the information, from the videos that we have been viewing all throughout this conference. We thank you, Lord, for again igniting our passion, and we just pray, Father, that indeed may this just be a beginning for our church again to intentionally be more involved in missions collectively as a church, and even individually, Father, as we reach out others for you. We pray, Father, that as we study your word tonight, you will open our eyes and our minds, that we will see the things that you would like us to see from the scriptures that we will be learning this evening. We pray, Lord, that you will be glorified in our midst and you rain your blessings upon us. In Jesus' name, amen. Sang nagligad niya gabi, we talk about missions has a price and we must be willing to make the sacrifice. As we focus on loving the lost, paying the cost, and making the most, isagali ka klaro-klaro sa aton yung mga natunan sa sining mga inadlaw kagabi, kagkagina sa aga, nga ang effort sa pagpangtaog sang kalag does not come free. It will have sacrifices and we must be willing to pay the price for it. Kagkaklaro man sa aton, sa mga gin-preach sa aton nga pwede kita gali kalakat, no? Pwede ta, as we are equipped, pwede ta kapangdaog sang kalag. Kung pamatsyag mo, ginatawag ka sang Ginoo sa mission field, kabay pagid, you will answer that call. No? Kag, ang pagkadto does not mean nga dapat mo pa-Afghanistan kagit, kay base tuod sa tupad balay mo lang, wala pa sila kakilala sa Ginoo, base sa classmate mo sa eskulahan or base office mate mo. Go does not mean crossing borders. Although ka-touching, kay kasakit sa buot, makalantaw ka sa mga videos kagina nga makita mo tuod nga diri sa Pilipinas, ya kisa gani gahipos na lang ta, kay nahuya ta. But we realize nga sa iba niya kalibutan, they have not heard the gospel yet. No, kung may mga young people di na ginatawag sa Ginoo sa paglakat, kabay pagi that you will live a faithful life now, be equipped, and when the time comes that God asks you to go, go. Kaya pwede man kita for now, tananta, collectively as a church, makapangamuyo. No? Kaya intentionally, para makapangamuyo ta, dapat damo, tanabalaan, nga mga palangamuyoan, kaya information, pagpis ato yung mga missionaries. No? So it takes for us a mind that is willing to know about the whereabouts sa maatong yung mga missionaries, whereabouts kung diin na, kung ano na kalapad ang reach sang gospel sang Ginoo, so that we can also pray wisely. And in our own respects also we can give. Okay, there is a church kinahimo tana nga practical. We have been calling to start another more serious and more intentional giving sa aton nga missions fund. Okay, as what we have said, pwede nga hindi magid amo na kadako-dako, no? Pero as the Lord blesses you, kabay pagid that ma-end ang ining nga missions conference kay makasugod ta with the commitment nga in my own ways kabay pagid nga maka-contribute ko sa bulaton sa Ginoo sa missions, no? And sa aton nga pledges kay gina, we can spare a portion, we can give unexpected income or unexpected gifts. Kung gusto ta gid, we can have a sideline kay pwede kita yung makasakripisyo, no? Kaya nga, akin na lang nga magsakripisyo because again, missions as a price, we must be willing to make the sacrifice. Pero kung tulukon mo, makambal ka bala, nga do ka negative sa perception. Nga do kambal ka, daw makambal ka, nga daw kabudlay-budlay git, nga ang mga missionary daw ga antus git. Pero ma-realize mo that in the Bible, ang pag-engage sa mission, in fact, is never a sacrifice, but a joy. Sa ginbasa, kagina sa context sa Romans chapter 10, nga nag-istorya ang si Paul parte sa kaluwasan, and anyone who will call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Nga ba sa verse 13, for whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And how then shall they call on Him whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in Him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? Kaya naghambal si Paul sa ginbasa ta kagina. And how shall they preach unless they are sent? As it is written, ginpresent ni Apostle Paul ang paglakad in a manner that it's beautiful and it's not a sacrifice after all. Ang term da kuno nga beautiful, gahalin sa word niya, very, very lovely. Kagang hambala, how beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace, who bring glad tidings of good news. Kay si Paul naghambal, as it is written, this can be traced back to the Old Testament in Isaiah chapter 52 verse 7. Nga ginhambal ni Isaiah, how beautiful upon the mountain are the feet of him who brings good news, who proclaims peace, who brings glad tidings of good things, who proclaims salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Kag sa pagtuon ko pala sini, kung magbalik ka kuno sa original nga context sini, it's like, nga anak baka, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Nga ara kuno gasaka sa bukid, kanaminami kuno sa mga tiil, nga gatakla sa bukid, kagahambal, peace. Kaya gahalin siya gali sa context ang war. Nga inang may mga messengers kuno, nga after sang war, pagkatapos ang gira, madlagan sila kay mambal, tapos ang gira, there is now peace and our God reigns. Kaya kung tulukon mo sa sina ang context, ang isa gali ka Kristohanon nga galakat, kagawitness, ang tiil niya galit daw pareho sa sininga mga tiil niya ginambal. You know what? The war of sin is over. There is now peace. So kung tulukon mo na ang picture, no? Kung ikaw na bigin hatagan sa privilege, halin ka sa war zone, nagkontrahanay, tapos gadlagan ka sa imo village, kagahambal, tapos ang gira, wala na gira, our God reigns. Amo na ambal ni Paul, kung ginatagan ka sa sina nga privilege, how beautiful are those feet nga nakatakla sa bukid, nagalatas ang kung ano da, just to bring a message of peace to the people. Kaya kung tuluhon mo, amo mangin ang mensahe, ha, di ba? Katuta sa opisina, mambal, you know, tapos ng gira, because Jesus Christ has already paid for our sins, and man can now have peace with God. God's kingdom has come. Amo na agin invite sa Ginoo kay ginasugo ito sa Acts 1:8, "You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, and in Judea, and in Samaria, and to the uttermost part of the earth, and to the ends of the earth." Nga daw pareho kasang messenger nga nakabati nga tapos ng gira, "I will go up in the mountains and proclaim the good news." Kaya kung magtulok na sini, I just would like to share nga kung may price tang bayaran, we have also a price to gain. And just going through a very familiar passage in Matthew chapter 10 verse 32 to 42, I just would like to share to you two price sa isa ka Kristohanon who gets involved in the work of the Lord. "Therefore, whoever confesses me before men, him I will also confess before my Father who is in heaven." In this context, confess kay witnesses ka sa Ginoo. So verse 33, "But whoever denies me before man, him will I also deny before my Father who is in heaven. Do not think that I came to bring peace on earth. I did not come to bring peace, but the sword." There's a context in Jesus, "For I have come to set a man against his father, a daughter against her mother, a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law." Kaya possibly, sharing God's news, becoming witnesses, will require you to get out of the comfort zones that you have. Verse 36, "And a man's enemy will be those of his household." Pero nagambas siya sa verse 37, "He who loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and he who loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And he who does not take his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me." Pero nagsabat siya, "But he who finds his life will lose it, and he who loses his life for my sake will find it." Kag ang reward sa verse 40, "He who receives you receives me, and he who receives me receives him who sent me. He who receives a prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive a prophet's reward, and he who receives a righteous man in the name of a righteous man shall receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives one of these little ones only a cup of cold water in the name of a disciple, assuredly I say to you, he shall by no means lose his reward." Makita tada ang context ni Jesus nga gambal siya nga, "If you will confess me before men, I will confess you before my Father. But as you follow me and become my witnesses, there will be discomforts. Because possibly, base, you will not bring peace, but rather a life nga kontrahon ka. Kaya makita ka nga, when you start to live a faithful life, gambal sa ato ng Bible, that you will expect a lot of sufferings as well. Pero sa sinaman niya passage, ka assure nga po magkabuhi ka kapara kay Kristo Jesus na ara sa patya. Kaya if you get involved in mission, I just would like to share to you two prizes. The first prize is a fulfilled life here on earth. Kaya nagambal ang verse 39, "He who finds his life will lose it, but he who loses his life for my sake will find it." Isa ka pinakadako nga problema subong sa kalibutan is depression. Number one mental health issue. Kaya kung tulukon mo ang ginapangita langgid sa mga tao nga gaka-depress is life's meaning. Magbalik ta sa Bible, you can find it in God. Kasubo lang nga ang ini nga mensahe hindi mabatian tungod we are so focused on ourselves. We are so focused on our lives. Pero gahambal lang, you know what? If you lose your life for my sake, you will find meaning in it. Isa pagit ka namin nga price, nga a-fulfilled ko na ang iniyang kabuhi. Sa Mark chapter 10, verse 29 to 30, "So Jesus answered and said, assuredly I say to you, there is no one who has left house or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or lands for my sake and the gospels, who shall not receive a hundredfold now in this life, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands may dugang lang siya galing nga pa rin, with persecution and in the age to come, eternal life. Pero you know what? Nanamiin ko plus ang sining nga example, nga kadungduman ko ginipermisi nung Errol nga gahambal, nga tuod nga wala sa balay kong maglibot-libot disa sa Pilipinas, sa kalibutan, pero ma-realize siya na may balay ito sa New York, may balay ito sa Manila, may balay ito sa Biscandiin. Kaya nga, ah, may utod to tumong. Kaya kung tulukon mo bala tuod ang isang kakabuhi nga ga-involve sa pag-alagad sa Ginoo, kung i-prioritize mo lang manggituod ang Ginoo sa imo kabuhi, the one that you are losing for Christ is eventually will be repaid 100-fold. Kaya mo lang nagaling eh, hindi talang pag-ihatag yung atong kabuhi. Kaya nakulbaan ta mag-prioritize sa Ginoo. Why is it fulfilling? Kaya kadamo sa mga utod mo that you become part of the body of Christ. Ang isa pa din karason niya nga, fulfilling siya. Si Paul kagina na namian ko sang wali naton sa siningaaga nga nagkabuhi siya sang sanaol nga tani amo man ang aton kabuhi, no? Kanya gambal sa yes you yourselves know that these hands have provided for my necessities and for those who were with me. Kay ang iyang experience, I have shown you in every way by laboring like this that you must support the weak and remember the words of the Lord Jesus that He said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Nakakabuhi si Paul sa sininga prinsipyo, more blessed to give than to receive. Kaya mabasahan tabala sa Proverbs, the generous soul will be made rich and he who waters will also be watered himself. Kaya klaro-klaro, ginabala kung gahatag ka sang imong kabuhi. Gahatag ka sang imong time. Gahatag ka sang imong resources. All the more, wala kaya gakakulang. No? Sa Tagalog, may ara na, pero may nga ginasabat, nauubos ako. No? Hindi na malabot sa sinangapunto na maubos ka. Because the biblical principle is, he who waters shall he himself be watered. So the generous heart, whatever you give, time, talent, treasure, will always go back to you. Kaya ang isa nga nga fulfilling ang kabuhi nga gaalagad sa Ginoo is sa Matthew chapter 28 verse 19 to 20 nagambal da ang Ginoo sang sugo ya, go therefore and make disciples of all nations baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Kaya nagambal siya, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always even to the end of the earth. Ang promise na pala ni Jesus, kung gago ka, gamake disciple, aray lang ganyang promise ko, I will be with you. Kisa base feeling, takis aga isahanon, ta sa siniya kabuhi, base blatuod, kumatsag, ta si Jesus, wala ga upod sa aton, kaya base blatuod, wala man kita gago. Kaya ang promise, da, kung manghimuon yun eh, teach, make disciples, aray lang ganyang promise ko, upod kita perme. I am with you all the way. Kag why is it fulfilling when God is with you? Sa Psalm 16:11, you will show me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Basi ang kabuhi mo, subong hindi fulfilling. Basi gamba ka sa kabuhi mo, subong akadamo, sang kulang sa akon. Masip pala tuod ang problema ta is being intentional in our service to the Lord. Because the price of service to God is a life of fulfillment here on earth. And the second price is a rewarded life in heaven. Kaginag yung quote man sa aton ang Matthew chapter 25. No? Kagina siya story sang tatlo ka steward nga ginatagan sang 5 talents, 3 talents, kag at 2 talents, kag 1 talent. No? Kag kung may isa pa siguro ka namin nga example, nga tani kita na. amuna tani ang tao nga naka-receive 5 talents. And by the way, ang 5 talents na is equal to 20 years of wages. No? So imagine nun muna, biskan 1 talent lang to ha. No? Inang million-million, gali ang ginbilin. Amo to nga, kung tulukon mo sa context ang unang, kinlubong niya lang ang pila ka million, kay nahadlok siya magasto. I think that's very, very, ang gapamati to siguro sa kay Jesus, mabaluo, no? At nga servant to, tamaran, manggito. Imagine, pila ka million, ginlubong niya lang. Okay, kung maglanta ako sa equivalent, 20 years of amount sa imong service. Te, ang goal ta tani, no, Lord, tani, pariyo ko sa steward nga ginatagan 5 talents. Okay, so verse 20, gamble. So, he who had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Lord, you delivered to me these 5 talents. Look, I have gained 5 more talents besides them. And his Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Kakanami nga pamatian, enter into the joy of your Lord. By pagid nga handom sang tagsa-tagsa ka Kristohanon makabati sang siningal line sa Ginoo, well done good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of the Lord. Kabay pagid nga indi ta magpareho sang isa nga nakakuha lang sang isa ka talent, nagambal siya, therefore take the talent from him and give it to him who has 10 talents. For everyone who has, more will be given, and he will have abundance. But from him who does not have, even that he has will be taken away. And cast that unprofitable servant into the outer darkness, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Okay, of course, makambal tanga, it will be a life of regret. Pero manumdum, tabla nga nga, nag-amuna ang iyakabuhi, no? I think it's really about his heart. So verse 24, then who had received 1 talent came and said, Lord, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you have not sown and gathering where you have not scattered. And I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Look, there you have what is yours. Ang issue sang 1 talent, hindi manggit kay kulang ang talent niya. Kaya kung tulukon mo, 20 years of wages. Pero ang issue sang isa ka may 1 talent is his heart. Amo na nga gin sa batses ang Ginoo, hindi ah, wicked ka lang gid ya, or tamaran ka lang gid. No? Recently, I read an article by Greg Morse sa Desiring God. Nakisabala, nga amo ning attitude da sa Ginoo. Kikis aga halin man ang atong pag-alagad sa pagpanumdum ta kung si sino nga Diyos ang may ara ta. Have you noticed na kung paano ka mag-perceive sa Ginoo mo, amo man na ang picture sa pag-alagad mo sa iya. Kasi si Greg Morse gahambal, if he only believed in the blessedness of this master's heart, that the master really meant to reward and welcome him into his own joy upon his return, how things might have been changed. The problem was not his master. Kagambal siya, hindi, Lord, ah, you're just hard. Hindi, Lord, ah, you're just strict. Pero the problem was not his master. The problem was his heart. The problem was not his abilities. The problem was his law. Kaya na-notice nyo, kaysa wala taga-alagad sa Ginoo, kaysa la-sala ang pagkilala, nagpagpanundong ta sa Ginoo. Nagduganda siya, what do you think of God? Does he give us serpents when we ask for bread? Is he watching with an eagle's eye to strike you when you stumble? Is he stingy, heartless, selfish? Does he tax a high rate and offer mere rations to strengthen for tomorrow's slavery? How does your life answer. Eksakto gid, no? Abi, usually, nga nga, wala taga-alagad sa Ginoo. Kaya may picture ta sa Ginoo. Nga Lord, istrikto ka man. Lord, you're a hard master. Silently do pareho ta sa servant with one talent. Nga ang pagpapati ta sa Ginoo, nga hindi siya maayo nga master, infiltrates our attitude affecting our service to God. Kaya ang conclusion ganit ni Greg Moore Sarbalya, beliefs about God's goodness can lead to a useful life with heaven to follow or a worthless life with hell close behind. Kag andaman tagali. Andaman ta, kung pamangkuton kasubong, ano ang pananaw mo sa Ginoo? Do you see Him as a master who is willing to give and reward your faithfulness? Or isa ka master nga, hindi ah, ginabantayan, yung una garmi, istrikto na sa, and is even not good. Kakisang kabuhi ta, miskan kis asa ba tagambal ta that God is good, but at the end of the day, ang attitude sa ating kabuhi, mambal nga, tuod, beliefs about God's goodness can lead to a useful life. Kaya kaginag yung example sa atong si Apostle Paul. Nga si Apostle Paul was able to fight the good fight, finish the race, kept the faith, kasi iya nga panlantaw sa kaayos sa Ginoo. So verse 8 na nga siya, finally, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not to me only, but to all who love His appearing. Kasi Paul gambal, my God is a righteous God who will reward me for all my efforts. Kaya namin, pala manumdum si Nat. Nga sa sinilang galing yung kabuhi, puno-puno ka na kung mag-alaga. Kasi Ginoo, you know, because it gives you a life of fulfillment in the next life to come, it will give you a life of reward. Kaya nga, makasali ka sa reward, kaya nag-promise sa Matthew, whoever gives one of these little ones only a cup of cold water in the name of a disciple. Name of a disciple pala na, cup of cold water pala na ang promise on, he shall by no means lose his reward. Why? Because he is a righteous, compassionate, loving, generous pastor. Kaya amunin nga kung magpadayon ka sa pag-alagad sa Ginoo, it will have rewards. May isa ko kananamian niya kanta when I was in the seminary. And ini siya sa context nga ang ga-istorya nagdamgo. Kasi isang pagdamgo, ya upod ya ang iyang amigo sa langit. And the title of this song is Thank You. Nanamian ako because it pictures the price for our efforts. Nga ginagmay or dinagko lang man. Ambalya, I dream I went to heaven and you were there with me. We walk upon the streets of gold beside the crystal sea. We heard the angels singing, then someone called your name. You turned and saw this young man and he was smiling as he came. And the young man, he said, friend, you may not know me now. And then he said, but wait. You used to teach my Sunday school when I was only 8. And every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. And one day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. Mga Sunday school teacher di, masiabi niyo, nga tulo-tulo lang sa mga bata, kaga action-action lang. Wala ka mo kabalo nga base sa isa mo kakatutom Sunday in and Sunday out serving the Lord. You don't know the lives that you're changing. Ang chorus gambal, thank you for giving to the Lord. I'm a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you came. Second stanza goes, then another man stood before you and said, remember the time a missionary came to your church and his pictures made you cry. You did not have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took the gift you gave, and that's why I'm here today. Nasi palaman, baka kagamay lang isang pledge ko, pero wala kakabalo. I-honor sa Ginoo. Ang ginbakal ba bulgam sa misyonary, alinto sa lima mo kapisos. Ago isang gaingkit-ingkit siya sa babulgam, may ginduhulan man sa babulgam, kag ato nga babulgam, nangin point of connection, and that person was saved. Kag wala takabalo, no? Jesus took that gift you gave, and that's why I'm here today. Kag kanamida asang pag-close ang stanza. One by one they came, far as the eyes could see, each one somehow touched by your generosity. Little things that you have done, basit ginagmay lang man, or sacrifices made, unnoticed on earth, in heaven, now proclaim. Kay the coda goes, and I know that up in heaven you're not supposed to cry, but I am almost sure there were tears in your eyes. As Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord, he said, my child, look around you, for great is your reward. And it closes, thank you for giving to the Lord. It could be your time. It could be your talent. It could be your money. It could be your life. Kaya wala kakabalo nga sa paghatag mo sina, somebody will say, I am a life that was changed. Kagabay, pagit nga tanan, ta makabati, sini sa langit, thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. Masimama ka, oh Lord, no, kanami nga, may masugata ka sa langit. Kaya malo, ang pinitla, kutugali nga pag, nga pag-share sa gospel, boy, biskan pinitla lang gali, may isa ka nagbago nga kabuhi. Agoy ang katapusan, tututani nga, inupliti ko lang ito galing, naglakat na lang ko, sige na lang. Gin-honor sa Ginoo, and kag ang katutom ko, wala man nakita, wala man na-acknowledge. But there will come a time that your righteous judge, your generous master, will reward you. Sigabay pagid niya mabatian pa na. May man tawag man to sa langit, uy, uy, salamat kita. Because you gave, and a life that was changed. Kaya sa tuod man gid, mission sa surprise, we must be willing to make the sacrifice. But on the end, in comparison to the price, missions is worth the sacrifice. Kagabay pagid nga, again, as a church and individually, this will encourage us to be more intentional in reaching the lost for Christ. Before I pray, I would like to give this silent moment for everyone to just pause and pray. Sa mga natun-an ta sa missions conference as we learn about loving the lost, about paying the cost, and about making the most of what we have. What is God telling you? I pray that you will be able to make small commitments to the Lord. Kaya wala takabalo where these small commitments will lead us. We hope and pray that this commitment will one day be honored by God. Makabati, ta well done to that faithful servant. Let's pray. Yes, Father, we Thank you. We thank you, Lord, for such a great privilege and invitation that you want us to join in this great commission of becoming beautiful feet that will bring good tidings to the world. We pray, Father, that you will give us grace and honor the commitment of your people. And as a church, Father, we pray that you will give us grace to be more intentional. Yes, there will be a price to pay, Lord, and we will be making sacrifices. But as we look forward to your great well done, we pray, Father, that you will make us count the cost, make the most of what we have, of the influence that you're giving us to reach others for Christ, knowing, Lord, that whatever sacrifice we make is worth our all. Thank you, Lord. May you honor the commitment of your children. In Jesus' name, amen.